From the way Mr. Beast started his YouTube career, no one would ever guess that his channel would be one of the most subscribed channels in the world. Jimmy Donaldson, or better known as Mr. Beast, hailing from North Carolina, has made quite a racket on YouTube. It all started on February 14th, 2012, on a channel named Mr. Beast 600 that was later deleted. His early content focused more on play videos to videos estimating the wealth of other YouTube stars. And all these were shaky videos made using his iPhone. And for many years, his videos never caught much attention. Fast forward to 2020, Mr. Beast's channel stands at 47.9 million subscribers with over 8 billion views in total. Within this year, he's uploaded 39 videos from which he received over 1 billion views. What's mind-blowing is not just his stats today, but how these numbers grew exponentially over the years. His rate of growth even surpasses the YouTube giant PewDiePie. Although PewDiePie is way ahead of Mr. Beast with 108 million subscribers, Mr. Beast has higher daily average subscribers and views. If you want that in figures, PewDiePie has an average of around 33,000 daily subscribers and around 6.8 million daily views. On the other hand, Mr. Beast has an average 50,000 daily subscribers and around 10 million daily views. Give him a few years and Mr. Beast may very well turn out to be PewDiePie's newest competition. So how did Mr. Beast grow at such a mind-boggling rate? That is exactly what we're gonna discover in this video. Keep watching if you want to take a crash course on achieving Mr. Beast's level of growth. So what's the big secret to his success? It's actually no secret, since Mr. Beast is very open to sharing and helping other YouTubers. I spent the last 50 hours researching for this video and I managed to find some key factors in achieving Mr. Beast's results on YouTube. It can all be boiled down to 5 simple points. Number 1, understanding the YouTube algorithm. Number 2, going viral. Number 3, reinvesting. Number 4, positivity. Number 5, effort. Mr. Beast's secret lies not in trying to beat the YouTube algorithm, but in trying to use the parameters to his advantage. In one of his many explanations to his fellow YouTubers, Mr. Beast explains that his breakthrough came when a friend showed him a graph of videos based on their click-through rate and average view duration. Mr. Beast figured out that videos with high click-through rates combined with high view durations did extremely better than videos with just one high parameter. He explains that what YouTube really wants is for people to click on a video and watch it, and then to keep clicking and keep watching. That's how they can build an audience and get ad revenue. So the best way to progress is to respect the platform. Aiming to increase your click-through rates and average retention rates would be the best way to make the algorithm work for you. Having found out what makes the algorithm work for him, the next step for Mr. Beast was to put all of this into practice. He dug deep into the small details of video making, assessing on how to get his numbers up. And one thing he mentioned in one of his interviews was, "Did they enjoy your last video?" Actually, Mr. Beast said that if someone loved your last video, you could bet that they are more likely to click on a video from your channel the next time it pops up. Was the video exciting enough to make viewers click through more of your videos? Adding a good hook is a great way of retaining the viewers' attention. Mr. Beast has loads of videos like "The Last to Leave Wins $100,000" or "I Spent 24 Hours in Ice." These kind of videos make people want to see what happens in the end, increasing both click-through rate and watch time. The next thing is going viral. Now, you're going to say that this is easier said than done. It's no industry secret that for most YouTubers, their viral video was a result of a humongous effort with a desperately try to reenact in the following videos. Rather than trying to figure out how to make a video go viral in the abstract, it would make your life much easier if you focus on the types of videos that go viral and aim for something similar. They say two heads are better than one, and having two YouTuber heads in one video is certainly better. Anything dealing with exorbitant sums of money also, quite unsurprisingly, grabs people's attention. Videos with generous amounts of drama of any form and prank videos are excellent at getting more shares and thereby views. Featuring a challenge can make your viewers watch the video until the end, thus increasing watch time. Finally, reaction-based videos also tend to pique curiosity. How Mr. Beast achieves viral videos one after the other is by making a video that combines two or more of these types. For instance, his latest video, I gave people $1 million but only 1 minute to spend it, is a challenge, which, as I have already said, is in itself a great way to get people to click and watch a video. But Mr. Beast made it money related and incorporated the actual drama of scrambling to shop in 60 seconds. Now, you're probably thinking that Mr. Beast has the privilege of doing that because he has truckloads of cash and plenty of contact. Not really. Back when he was less known, the videos that got him popularity followed the exact same logic. They were bizarre challenges he'd put himself through where he filmed his own reactions. Mr. Beast made use of the resources he had in the most effective ways to get the most out of it. Another trick Mr. Beast uses is with the thumbnails and video titles. Scroll through his channel and you'll see that Mr. Beast's videos use apparently simplistic thumbnails to the point that they may even be called poorly made. But these thumbnails spot on achieving their purpose. They're direct yet unique. The thumbnail is a perfect yet simple picture summary of the entire video, unlike most thumbnails which are confusing at best and sometimes downright misleading. Also, Mr. Beast wastes no time in getting to the point. This can encourage sharing with the first few seconds of the video and keep the viewers' attention at the outset. Viewers know that his content is to the point, no fluff stuff, and that they deliver exactly what they promise. This confidence can go a long way in retaining and reaching new viewers. In an interview with Casey Neistat, Mr. Beast said that his approach to growth was to reinvest, reinvest, and reinvest. Every time he received a paycheck, it was the month's budget for his channel. The more money he made, the more he spent on his videos. That is how he maintained continuous growth, because of the benefits of his growth doubled back onto the channel itself. As his earnings rose exponentially, his video budget increased exponentially, allowing him to create better videos every single time. This is what sets Mr. Beast apart and higher from the rest. His earnings are not spent on himself. They are spent on making his videos and make up for the content in his videos. That is how he manages to give away so much money, which attract more viewers, which earn him more money, and you get the picture. So by spending and giving away his money, he is in effect making more money. Mr. Beast follows a theme of positivity throughout all his videos. How many scandalous videos are you seeing in trending right now? Although Mr. Beast creates a bit of drama in his videos, it's never at the cost of another person. In fact, almost all his videos focus on giving either to his friends, challenge winners, or to absolutely random people. This positivity has proven invaluable in gaining an established fan base. Genuity is another striking feature in all his videos. Mr. Beast is a down-to-earth guy. These little things make you likable as a person, and people will want to watch your video simply because it features a beautiful and a wholesome personality. Mr. Beast achieves this level of genuity by focusing on his passions. Advising a fellow YouTuber, he pointed out that it's important to find out something that he likes. Building up a great YouTube channel can take years in the making. So if you're not doing something that you at least like, it's going to be harder for you to get traction. And that's sure to be reflected through the content that you create. Mr. Beast is certainly not into cutting corners when it comes to his videos. He tries to put in as much work as possible into making the best video possible, be it a 15-second clip or a 15-minute video. Viewers notice it when you go the extra mile, and they're obviously going to want to keep watching quality content that is focused on giving them the best experience. A little obsession never hurt anybody, right? Mr. Beast's method is to hyper-obsess on his channel goals. This doesn't mean that you have to live and breathe YouTube 24/7. Oh, wait, we do mean something along the lines. Mr. Beast's initial videos that gave him his boost were of him doing some long, repetitive act for hours, like counting to 100,000, spinning a fidget spinner for 24 hours, and watching his everyday bro for 10 hours straight. He said that in the end, he had to listen to music to get the video out of his brain so that he could sleep. Now, that is some serious dedication. So there you have it. That's how the up and rising YouTube stars creates his stardom. Which one of these do you struggle with the most? Let me know in the the comments below. Can we get this video to 10,000 likes? And be sure to check the link in the description where I'm showing you how you can generate an income online with YouTube and affiliate marketing.